to extend a warm welcome to all of you who are able to join us today. It's a wonderful opportunity for our community to join together to recognize all those who've served and those who've sacrificed their lives so their fellow Americans may live in freedom and safety. How do we grateful Americans ever begin to repay such an enormous debt of gratitude? One way is by recognizing them on occasions such as Memorial Day. We gather today to remember and honor the sacrifices of so many men and women who fought for and paid the ultimate price for our country and all that we cherish. They fought and died so that we would continue to live in a country that assures its citizens of the many freedoms we need to treasure and protect. Their duty was to serve, and our duty is to remember. To remember and honor them and their families every day, but especially on Memorial Day. I'd like to introduce and recognize our two honored guests today. They are both here today representing with great honor all that is best with our community and our country. They will be laying the memorial wreath. Ralph Angeline, Sergeant, U.S. Air Force, received a Medal of Good Conduct and is serving as the Grand Marshal for the 2024 Memorial Day ceremony. Thank you, Ralph, for your service. Beekman's privileged to have you and your family joining us. Staff Sergeant Jonathan Reyes will be giving our Memorial Day address. Beekman is privileged to have you and your family with us. Jonathan, I have more about Jonathan. Sorry. He's 15 years Army National Guard 42nd Infantry Division Air Assault Staff Sergeant, was deployed 2022 for Operation Spartan Shield and was stationed in both Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, and Qatar, and was deployed as a senior non-commissioned officer for the command team of the 369th. He's currently state active duty, where he holds the position of squad leader on the Joint Task Force Empire Shield. The Joint Task Empire Shield is an element of New York State Division of Military and Naval Affairs, a counterterrorism unit partly responsible for the military defense of New York City. It's primarily the deterrence and prevention of internal security threats, which was established after the tragic day of 9/11. At this point, please stand for posting of the colors. Post the colors. Please place your right hand over your heart or salute if you're in uniform for the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be led by Girl Scout Troop 10547, followed by our national anthem sung by Katrina Skorowitz.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Star-spangled banner yet wave.
standing, I'd like to welcome Reverend John Rembert from the Mount Zion Baptist Church, who will pray the invocation.
Good morning. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we pause today to remember those who have served in the Army, in the Navy, in the Marines, the Air Force, the Coast Guard, those who have given their lives for our freedom, we acknowledge that today and every day is yours. We thank you for giving us this opportunity to honor, to remember the men and women who have bravely served this country in the past as well as in the present. We thank you for those brave souls who selflessly gave all of themselves without asking anything in return. We ask you to bless the families of these warriors who stayed behind while their loved ones went into battle and never returned. Let peace prevail among all the nations. God, let your mercy rest upon our land. Even as we acknowledge your goodness in this world, we ask that you preserve the lives of the men and women in uniform as they defend our nation. We pray that they will return, that we pray that you will return, turn their hearts of all military and civilian people to your holy word, where we can find the true peace and comfort in our souls. We thank you for all that you do. Let us not ever forget the reason why this day and for this sacrifice that was made by our brothers and sisters. Lord, this is our prayer on this Memorial Day. In the name of Jesus we pray, and we say amen, amen. And amen, and amen.
Please have a seat. I'd like to welcome Staff Sergeant, except everyone, but Staff Sergeant Jonathan Reyes. He's going to speak at the moment. Thank you.
Everybody, thank you for showing up. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody that served in the military, past and present, thank you for being here. Young ladies, everybody, thank you for following in our footsteps. Today we gather on this Memorial Day to honor the brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice for our nation. We stand here in freedom and in peace because of their courage and dedication. Our fallen heroes came from all walks of life, but were united by their love for this country and their willingness to defend it. They were fathers, they were mothers, sons, daughters, friends, even our neighbors. Most importantly, they were troops, soldiers. They stood strong in the face of danger, embodying the values of duty, honor, and selflessness. As we reflect on their sacrifices, let us draw strength and pride from their legacy. Their courage reminds us that the resilience that defines our military and our nation. We must carry their torch forward, upholding the principles they fought for and striving to build a future worthy of their sacrifice. Serving in the military is more than a duty. It is a profound honor. It means standing with the finest men and women ready to protect our freedoms and uphold our values. It means being a part of something greater than ourselves, a legacy of resilience and pride that endures through the generations. Today, as we remember our fallen heroes, let us renew our commitment to serving with the same bravery and determination. Let their sacrifices inspire us to be resilient in the face of challenges and unwavering in our dedication to this great nation. Let us not forget them, but also let us not forget our veterans that are still here with us today. Thank you, and may we all honor the memory of those who gave everything for our freedom. God bless you all, and God bless America.
Thank you. At this point, it is our tradition that individuals stand as their service hymn is heard during the playing of the military service medley. Sorry.
Thank you.
Please stand and place your right hand over your heart or salute if you're in uniform as the wreath is laid and the Green Haven Color Guard honors our fallen with a 21-gun salute.
Right here, just wait 1 second. I'm sorry, but they're not. Want to lay it up there or next to it, whatever you want to take it down and lay it next to that? Yeah, so it doesn't fall, I guess.
Put it right in the front?
Yeah.
I think I should turn it the other way, no?
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed? When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shine. praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see.
On behalf of the members of the town board, we'd like to thank all of you who've joined us today. We'd especially like to express our deep appreciation for all those who've served our country in all branches of the military. A special thank you to Rafael Deneen and Staff Sergeant Jonathan Reyes for their participation today. I'd also like to thank the Sunflower Farm for their flowers, our maintenance department, Andrew and Art, for their assistance. Thank you to the Highway Department for their assistance with the Hometown Heroes banners. Thank you to the Beekman Fire Department's Color Guard, Green Haven's Color Guard, the Dutchess County Sheriff's Color Guard, Girl Scout Troop 10547 for joining us today. Thank you, Pastor Jordan and Rembert, for your spiritual guidance as always. Thank you to those who added their musical talents to today's ceremony, Katrina Skorowitz, to Kayla Outman, Caitlin Mitchell, Jimmy Amato, and Cooper Hoffman. Thank you to Video Ventures, the Beekman Fire Department for hosting the barbecue following this ceremony, Troop 77 for the flags that are placed at Beekman Cemetery across the street. A special thanks to our town clerk, Laureen, for making this day special for all of our veterans. At this point, I'd like to ask you to stand and have Pastor John Jordan join us for the benediction. He is the pastor of Beekman Baptist Church.
Good morning, and welcome to Beekman Baptist Newtown. Okay. At this time, we'd like to say a little prayer. And when you say the benediction, it's only a few little words, but it means so much to a lot of people. It also opens your heart to understand what we're here for. We're here for to dedicate and honor those who have fallen for us. We have lived a long time in this country compared to the fact that they had died so many years ago. But we should be honored and thankful for the fact they did give their lives unwillingly sometimes, just so that we could have life, have it more abundantly. So let us pray. Father God, we're so thankful for this you have done for us, the many blessings you restored upon each and every one of us. We don't deserve some of the things we do have, but we thank you for it. We thank you for your Son, your Holy Spirit. We also thank you for the soldiers who went forward, not knowing what's going to happen, whether they'll come back home or not. But it's a blessing to know those who did come back home who have time to live and face the reality that they have faced. And at the time, I'd like to say thank you for all those who are here and bless them and every day they do and everything they say. And we ask this in the Son Jesus' name. Amen.
At this time, retire the colors.
Land that I love, beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairie to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home.
Thank you, and God bless all of you for coming today to remember. Thank you.